It's a pretty well-known fact that selling a product on the internet is one of the most guaranteed ways to make money online. And in my last video, I talked about how you can make money selling your artwork on Teespring. Now, but the biggest question really is, how do you know what people are currently buying so you can know what to sell? Because even if you sell the right product, at the wrong time, you get frustrated because no one is going to buy. So that's why in today's video, I'm going to walk you through the process of identifying what people are currently buying and then selling that product to them. But in this video, we'll be using selling t-shirts as an example. So if you're interested in selling other products as well, then you can also go ahead and use the knowledge that you're going to learn in identifying what people are currently buying and sell those products. I've also done a more detailed video on how to identify what people are currently buying. So if you are interested in watching that as well, I will link the video up here. You can watch it so you can learn what people are currently buying, so you can know how to set up the right product to sell on the internet. This is very essential. If not, your business will not be as successful as it should be. So essentially, we'll learn three things today. One, how to identify what people are currently buying. And then two, how to now set up that product and then sell it on Teespring. We're using Teespring and selling t-shirt as an example in this video. We can apply this as well on other business model like dropshipping and all of that. So if you're ready, we're going to jump right into this video. But in case we are meeting for the first time, my name is David Ongwa and I create content on online entrepreneurship and short videos of places and things that I find very interesting. So consider clicking that subscribe button, because I guarantee you the content I release here is something that will benefit you and something that will help your journey on making money online much smoother and much easier. So without further ado, let's jump into today's video. To identify what you're going to sell, we are going to use the tool called Krito. With Krito, you get to know exactly what people are currently buying. It's one of the best platforms for when it comes to market research and product to sell. And also breaks down what people are currently buying depending on the sector. Now you can find apparel, but beside apparel, you also find consumer electronics and then groceries. So each of the categories, it breaks it down for you and then lets you know what people are buying in those categories. So you can decide to go ahead and sell any of those products that you find that are currently being bought by customers. But for this video, we are concentrating our efforts on apparel. So we're going to go back to apparel and then see what kind of apparel people are currently buying. So when you take a look at this apparel, you find the graph that is being drawn. The graph shows you how the sales is going, how people are buying. So if we check out this graph right now, you find that the highest thing people are currently buying are shorts. So shorts are the highest sellers right now. So people are currently buying shorts in terms of apparel. So you can decide to begin selling shorts, because that is what people are really buying based on this statistics we are getting from Krito. Now, shorts is the highest selling, but there are also other ones that are also selling. So if you look at the second highest seller as well, is skirts. Skirt is like skirt, short skirts. So those are the highest selling. And then you can see from the graph how the trend of the sales. Sometimes you find that it's high, sometimes you find that it's low. Now, the third one you find there is baby clothing. So people are actually really buying baby clothing as well. So we've seen three things. You have the shorts, the short skirt, which is a skirt, and then you have the baby clothing. So these are the three major things that are selling in terms of apparel. So you can pick those three and begin to sell, or you can decide to pick any of them. So in this example, because I'm selling clothing, in this example, I'm going to pick baby clothing. So because I've seen from the trend that baby clothing are currently selling right now very well. So I'm going to pick baby clothing. Then after we've identified that baby clothing are selling from Krito, so the next thing we want to do is to either go over to Google and do a search on baby clothing so we can get an idea to see what kind of designs people are currently selling on baby clothing. The next thing I want to do also is to head over to Eastie. Now, Eastie is one of the biggest marketplaces when it comes to sales of t-shirts or apparel or all kinds of items. Now, on Eastie, we'll find various t-shirts that are currently selling. So if I pick this very one, this is Little Darling. You can see one of the most, you can see that this shirt is selling. However, when I point my mouse over here, although you see this number doesn't actually represent this particular shirt. It represents the total number of comments or likes that the store have gotten. So to make sure that this item is currently being bought, so what I normally do is to go down over to the comment section of this shirt and then see if their recent comment in terms of if customers who recently bought these items have commented. So that way I get to know that yes, this shirt has been sold. So if you check now, you can find that in May, somebody bought this shirt in May and also commented on it. So that means this shirt is currently being bought as we speak. And so which is a good indication that baby clothing are being sold right now. So with that being said, we've essentially done three things right now. We've identified two creatures that baby clothing are selling, and then also we've checked Google, and then we've seen that people are uploading designs on a daily basis in terms of baby clothing. So we've gotten some ideas from Google, and also we've gone to Eastie, which is the biggest platform when it comes to sales of items. And then we've seen that also baby clothing are selling. They have also seen a sample design. So the next thing now is for us to move over to Teespring and then create an account on Teespring. You've identified your product. The next point is to create an account on Teespring. Now, creating an account on Teespring is very simple. On this video, I'm not going to walk you through step-by-step way to create an account so that this video doesn't get longer than it should be. But it's a very simple process. Just click on register or start designing and then follow the process through. It's very simple. However, if you think you are going to find challenge in terms of creating your store, I'll also link a video, I'll link another video that Teespring have explained the process. So I'll link it on the description. So just check the description of this video. You can find it there and then you can follow through the process. But beside that, it's very simple. You click on register and then you just follow through the process and then you register your store. But the most important thing I'd like to point out when it comes to registering on Teespring is that, like I explained in my previous video, Teespring pays you in two channels. They pay you through PayPal and they pay you through Payoneer. So if you live in countries, mostly Africa, where PayPal is not fully supported in terms of receiving and withdrawing your cash, your best option is to use Payoneer. So after you register with Teespring, you need to move over to Payoneer and register an account with them. Once you register an account with Payoneer, Payoneer gives you a US bank account through which you can receive your money, And once you receive your money in that Payoneer account, you can automatically transfer that money to your local bank account. So you need to have a local domiciliary bank account with any of the banks wherever you're watching from the world. If you're in Nigeria, you can just do that, register and have that. So after you register with Payoneer and then you register with Teespring, you need to go over to Teespring at the setting page. You'll find where you can link your Payoneer account with your Teespring account. So you just click on link and then you automatically link that account with your Payoneer account. So now once the account has been linked, any money that you make from Teespring will be transferred to your Payoneer account. And once the money is on your Payoneer account, you can transfer that money to your local account. So this is how you get your money. So that's the most vital thing I want to point out in terms of registering with Teespring and receiving your money. Okay, that being said, the next point of call now is for us to move over to designing our products. So we need to design our product. And to do that, you need to select what kind of apparel you want to sell on Teespring. So basically, we've seen that we want to sell baby clothing because that is what is selling. And there are various baby clothing you can find. But in this case, I would decide to sell, pick a particular baby clothing to sell. So the baby clothing could be toddler t-shirts. It could be baby as in a little baby, where you have baby suits and all of that. So once you select what you want, then you can begin designing. So in this case, I'm going to select that. And once you click it, it brings you to this point where you click on sell. And then once you click on sell, the design interface of Teespring will open up. So at the design interface, you can see there is the back and there is the front. And you have the preview. You also have the design. So with the design, you can see how it works. So basically on the design, you have this red box there. This red box is where your design must be. Your design must not go outside the red box. If it goes outside the red box, it will not be printed. Anything within the red box will be printed. And you'll find that there are two ways you can also upload your design. So you can add an image. So adding an image is uploading the design you've already done. And then the second thing is you can just add text. So you can simply just add text on the t-shirt. And then that's it. Also, if you look down, you'll find that you can select various colors of shirt you want to sell. So currently this is white, but you can select other colors that your designs will be on. Essentially, I would recommend that you don't select too many colors. The color you select should be between 2 and 4, maximum, between 2 and 4. So that gives your customers an option to select different colors. But when you have more than 4, you have too many colors, it actually can lead to confusion. So your customer gets in, then they start, you know, they get confused on what to pick and all of that. So just limit the color between 2 and 4. And then after you've selected the color, it will appear there. So let's look at adding text. So like I said, adding text is simple. You just click on the text and then you add the text you want to put on the shirt. Remember, like the shirts we saw that's being sold on Etsy, it's just a simple text. There wasn't anything special about the shirt. Just a simple text that was added to the shirt. So you can also do that by adding your own text on this Teespring. But I will not recommend that you use Teespring design interface to design your shirt. The reason being because with this, you cannot actually take this design and then re-upload it in other platforms that sells t-shirts. But if you have your own design, it's easier for you to use that same design and re-upload it in other platforms like Spreadshirt, like Redbubble, and then sell the same t-shirt designs there. So in this case, now we're going to just pick a design that I've already made. So let me just pick that and then upload it on the shirt. So now I've uploaded this on the shirt. So you can see how it looks. It's still a simple text that I've done. So one thing I want to point out is once you upload your text, your graphics, Teespring will let you know if that graphics is good enough. It's a good quality in terms for printing. So you can see it shows the quality is good. So, but if it shows that the quality, print quality is poor, you need to actually re-upload another graphics. The reason being because once the shirt is printed, the print will not come out very well. So you need it, the quality to be good. So when you are designing, make sure that your resolution of your image is very high so that once you upload it, the print quality will still be very good. Okay, so that being said, if you position this, you can also test out the colors of the shirt that you've selected so you can get to see how they look on your design. So that's the next thing you want to do. And then let's take a look at the pricing. So Teespring gives you a range. It tells you how much the shirt sells for. And then it gives you a range of what you can sell it. But what you can do also is to compare your prices with what you've seen from your research, like in Etsy and other platforms, so you can see how much shirts have been sold there. So that gives you an idea what kind of price to put for your shirt. And then Teespring, you know, have given you a particular range, but you can reduce it. And when you reduce it or you increase it, you can see your profit margin and all of that from your price that you've set up. So after you set up your price, you just click and then it will bring you over to this page. So now what we're going to do is to add more products. So at the beginning, we selected just one product, which is the baby suit. But because it's kids clothing that we find, baby clothing, so we want to add like toddlers, t-shirt and all of that. So it's not just the baby suit we're going to sell. We're also going to sell for toddlers. We're also going to sell maybe singlets or so. So Teespring also gives you that option. So you can scroll down and select more items that you want to add to your design that you want to sell. So what I've done now is to select the toddler classic tee. So I have the baby clothing, I have the toddler, and all of that being selected. So essentially I have three products that I'm going to sell with this design. Then once you're done, you click and then you come over to where you now customize your wording. So you put in the title and the description of your shirt. So what I've done here, I've just copy and paste the description and the title I have done. So the next thing basically you want to do is to select the color of the shirt that will be at the up the front, the really one that will be displayed up front. So by default it's using white, but in case I don't want to use white, so I can pick what color I want and then make that to be the default color that customers see once they come to this page to buy the shirt. So you can pick. So I have essentially four colors and I'm going with white. Okay, so basically that's it. Here you have automatic URL generated for you. So this URL is what you're going to use to also sell your shirt. Like if you want to promote your shirt on Facebook through Facebook ads, or you want to promote it on Instagram, either with ads or without ads, you can do that, you know, using the URL so that people can click and then come over to Teespring and buy your shirt. So the URL also, you can customize it if you want. And then visibility, you leave it at public. So that's very essential so people can see it. And then the next thing is you've created a store. So but this design, now you want to add it to your store. So you just click on that and then you select which of your stores that you've created. You can create multiple stores on Teespring and then add it there. So essentially, once you've done that, your product listing is ready to go. Yes. Okay, so here it is. And you can find that the shirt is automatically created. So, and then I can change the colors to see how it looks like. So this is it. This is how you create your product on Teespring. And then you start selling it. So the next step now is to promote this shirt on social media, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, whatever social media platform you want to sell it, and give the URL to your on the promotion so that people can come to your store and then buy the shirt. So is that simple. So if you also want to learn how to promote your t-shirt, you may probably using a paid advertisement, Facebook paid ads. I've also done a video on that. You can check it out and then see how you can promote your design now on Facebook, which is very, very essential in terms of market promotion. So that's it on this video. So essentially, we've learned three things. We've discovered how to know what is selling, and then we moved over to Teespring and then designed it, and then now we are done with the design. The next thing is to go ahead and promote this t-shirt on social media and sell your shirt. Okay, so if you have any questions on this video, please put it on the comment section and I will do my best to attend to it. And if you also want to learn how to promote your t-shirt or how to promote your designs through Facebook ads. Check out the other videos on the description as well, so you can learn how to promote your design. All right, if you have any questions, please drop it down so we can deal with it. And that will be it for this video, and I will see you on the next one. Don't forget to check out my other videos in the channel so you can learn a little bit more. See you on the next video. Bye.